Dear friends, in class 9 we are studying 7 chapter triangles, and in that chapter we are studying inequalities in a triangle. Now next theorem number 8 is the sum of any two sides of a triangle is greater than the third side. Means we need to prove that if this is triangle ABC, we have to prove that AB plus BC, that is the sum of two sides of triangle is greater than third side. AB plus BC is greater than AC. We have to also prove that AB plus AC is greater than BC, and we have to prove that AC plus BC is greater than AB. So these three terms we need to prove. See, the sum of any two sides of a triangle, so these are sum of two sides, it is greater than the remaining third side. This is what we need to prove. Now see, we are given triangle ABC, this much is only given, and we have to prove this. To prove AB plus AC is greater than BC, AB plus BC is greater than AC, and AC plus BC is greater than AB, that is sum of any two sides is greater than the third side, that is what we need to prove. So for this we are going to construct this point D, construct point D such that this AC is equal to AD. This AD and AC is one and the same. So this is what is our construction is. I will draw a little properly. So we are given a triangle ABC. We have to extend this BA such that this AC will equal to AD. We will take D point and join CD. So this is what is the construction is. So construction is, draw segment AD or extend BA up to point D, up to D, such that AC equals AD. AC is equal to AD. Now consider triangle ACD. Consider triangle ACD. In this we have got AC equal to AD. So here AC equals to AD. This is our construction. Now in isosceles triangle theorem we have studied that angles opposite to congruent sides are equal. That is, angles opposite to congruent sides are congruent. It means these two sides are congruent. It means angles opposite to them are this. They must also be congruent. So according to isosceles triangle theorem, angles opposite to congruent sides are congruent. Angles opposite to congruent sides are congruent. So here we will get angle ACD equals to angle ADC. Watch carefully. I have got ACD equals to angle ADC. Now see, if ACD is equal to ADC, if you add this angle to this, sum of these two angles will always be greater than the angle ADC. Means, if you add only to one side, since it is equality, if you add only to left hand side, angle ACD plus angle ACB must be greater than angle ADC. Watch carefully. This was equal. I have added only this ACB, a non-zero angle to this angle. And if non-zero number is added to equality, this left hand side will surely become more or will surely become greater. It means angle ACD plus ACB is greater than angle ADC. Now look at the figure. ACD plus ACB, this total, we can add, they are adjacent angles, so we can add them. It means I will get angle BCD is greater than angle ADC. This is what we have got. Now watch carefully. Angle BCD is this, angle ADC is this. Now for angle ADC, I can name it BDC, same angle. Please note, it is a common angle named by two in two different ways. So I have to get angle BCD is greater than angle BDC. BDC, this is ADC and BDC is one and the same. Watch carefully. ADC also same and BDC is also the same angle. Now here what, BCD is greater than angle BDC. It means, we have already studied before this, that sides opposite to larger angle is larger, or side opposite to greater angle is greater. Now watch carefully. BCD is this angle, so side opposite to this is BD, and side opposite to BDC, BDC is this. So I will get BD is greater than BC. Reason is, we have just proved the theorem earlier, either 6 or 7, in this theorem 6 or 7, we have proved that sides opposite to greater sides are greater. Sorry, greater angle is greater. Side opposite to greater angle is greater and smaller angle is smaller. E in a triangle, this is definitely in a triangle, so we will write E in a triangle, side opposite to greater angle is greater. So we have what, BD is greater than BC. Now watch carefully. BD is nothing but BA plus AD. BD is nothing but BA plus AD is greater than BC. But our construction was AD equals to AC. AD equals to AC, so I can interchange this. I will get BA plus AC is greater than BC. Watch carefully. BA means this side, AC means this side, and BC means this side. So in triangle ABC, I have got sum of two sides is greater than the third sides. So here I have got, therefore, AB plus AC is greater than BC. That is the first. AB plus AC is greater than BC. Now, if you have proved sum of two sides is greater than third side, similarly, we can prove the other two also. AB plus BC is greater than AC and AC plus BC is greater than AB. But for that, we will have to do the construction in a different ways. So, similarly, I am writing here, similarly, we can prove AB plus BC is greater than AC, and AC plus BC is greater than AB. Thus, we can say that sum of any two sides of a triangle is greater than the third side. Dear friends, we have solved example 9. I am explaining the 9th example. D is a point on side BC of triangle ABC. So we have considered triangle ABC. In triangle ABC, D is a point on side BC. D is a point on side BC of triangle ABC such that AD equals AC. This AD equals AC show that AB is greater than AD. We have to do that. This segment AB is greater than AD. So let us write the given things. In triangle ABC, D is a point on side BC. So D is between B and C, is written something like this, B, D, C, and is read as D is between B and C, such that AD equals AC, AD equals AC. This is also given to us. So these are the three parts given to us. We have to show that AB, this segment, this side, to show AB is greater than AC. Now see how it can be proved. Consider triangle ADC. In triangle ADC, we are given that AD equals AC. AD equals AC. Now, if we have studied according to isosceles triangle theorem, according to isosceles triangle theorem, Angles opposite to congruent sides are congruent. It means angle ADC equals angle ACD. Watch carefully. Now, see, this angle is an exterior angle to the triangle ABD. But angle ADC is an exterior angle of triangle ABD. We have already studied that angle is called exterior angle, which makes a linear pair with the interior angle of a triangle. Now in triangle ABD, ADC is an exterior angle. We know that exterior angle is equal to sum of remote interior angles, or we can say that exterior angle is always greater than remote interior angles. It means angle ADC equals angle ABD plus angle BAD. So it is sum of two angles. So I can say that angle ADC is always greater than the remote interior angles. But I need this angle ABD is always greater than ABD. Now look, ADC is equal to ACD. So I can say that, give this equation number 1. From equation 1 I will get angle ACD is greater than angle ABD. Now look at the figure. ACD is this and ABD is this. I can call this ACD as ACB and ABD as ABC. So I will get angle ACD is nothing but angle ACB. Angle ACB is greater than angle ABC. ABD is nothing but ABC. I am naming it by another alphabets. So ABD is ABC. I have got ACB greater than ABC. Please note, I have got this angle is greater than angle ABC. It means side opposite to greater angle is greater. This means AB is greater than AC. Therefore, AB is greater than AC. And the reason is sides opposite to greater angle is greater. Sides opposite to greater angle is greater.